Hey everybody, welcome back. We got a new portal today, so I thought I'd do a real quick video and do some summons just to see what if we get anything. I got some offers yesterday for food and feeders, and I ended up with some of these coins for this event. So we'll use those, and let's talk real quickly about Seto here. Seto? Not sure. Anyways, I'm not super impressed with these, I have to say, other than her attack stat being ridiculous. Almost 1,000, and this is not limit broken. So her attack is sick. But she deals 300% damage to the target and 150% damage to all other enemies at average speed. That's good. She's like a, I mean, at that's at fast speed. So she's like a mix between Jove. She hits like Jove, only with a lot less damage. And then she gives the same ailment as Anne. So she's like a toned down version of if Jove and Anne had a baby. This is what it would look like right here. And then second is at average speed, deals 415 damage, and everything else is the same. So 207.5% damage. To all other enemies. I mean, if I get her, yeah, she's a decent hero, but she's definitely not a chase hero by any means. There's a lot of other really good heroes in blue. So Ephira, honestly, I really don't like these types of heroes. All she does is summon a pretty beefy minion for each ally and then gives a stack. So if she goes off numerous times, you end up with, you know, the second time she goes off, you're going to get a minion with 37% HP. And then the next time it'll be 42% HP. Honestly, I don't think that the HP even matters, because if I see her out there, I'm putting in Grimble and just going to town on this team. So if I get her, I would not level her. I wouldn't waste the mats. I really don't like just minion, straight up minion heroes. And then LaSalle, he's a deals 400% damage with a really high attack stat. He's a one-hit sniper who hits really hard and then leaves a fiend behind, and that fiend replicates itself. So, you know, 22% attack every turn. It's not super high. I mean, it's actually super low, but because the minion replicates itself over time, that can be annoying to, well, I guess the defense is AI, but that can really absorb their healing and do some damage over time. Now, we also have a new 3-star here, Yako. Let's see. Steals 33% mana from the target and distributes it to its allies. Deals 235% damage to the target, minor damage to nearby enemies. So, I like that he prioritizes the mana steal so he doesn't kill the hero and not steal the mana. I think he's a pretty decent 3-star. Definitely level him up and use him in those 3-star tournaments. So that's about all there is to talk about. I didn't get him last time. So Forces, I would like to get him. There's still some costumes. I don't have Ursina. I do like the Reflect. So that Reflect of Holy, that can come really in handy, especially when you're going against a team that's got like a defense team that they've got three Holy heroes in there, which you're seeing more of now. So it should be really good there. And then got a bunch of season ones. I still don't have Ariel's costume here. Did pick her up in the last one, but I'm not super enthused about her. I've got a lot better blue heroes. And Lapago, he's a good minion destroyer, but I don't know, Gobbler, I think is, let's see, deals 230% damage to all enemies. All allies get plus 30% defense. Gobbler in here. Can't remember if he's actually in this. No, he's not. But anyway, I'm just not super impressed with this portal. Like I said, I wouldn't be summoning in here if I didn't just have the coins. So let's see. I've seen some other people have some luck in this portal today. Yeah, and with a portal that seems pretty weak with the new heroes. Darius, I've already got him. He's slow speed. I do not like, especially 4 stars, because, oh, Galapago, hey. All right, I'll take that. Nice. I'll have to compare him to Gobbler in a second here. See if he's worth it. I have Matt, and I have Green Knight, and I've leveled them up to 370, but I haven't pulled the trigger. I have enough mats. Yako, good. I did want him. I have enough mats to do one green hero, but I need a defensive specialist in green. I don't need any more defense down heroes, and I don't need any more hitters. Got plenty of both of those. I just can't put a good team together because I don't have a defensive specialist. Three more. Yeah, it looks like everybody that I've talked to has gotten a 5-star hero in those first 10 pulls. All right, that's it for the summons. Let's take a look at Galapago here. And we did just look at him, but okay, it destroys all minions, 230% damage, and plus 30% defense. All right, so I want to take a look at, unfortunately, I don't have him leveled. But let's look at him anyways. Where are you at here? I was just looking at him not too long ago. Gobbler. So at average speed, it deals 135. I don't know what that goes up to. Probably somewhere in the 185. Damage to all enemies, and all allies recover 80 HP for each destroyed minion. So usually there's between 5 to 10 minions out there by the time one of these heroes, these anti-minion heroes, goes off. So you're looking at 400 to 800 HP recovery. So he's not a bad healer, like a hero that can get rid of minions and heal up. His defense, his attack is pretty weak, though, I guess, compared to Galapago here. .230 and then .310. And here it's just the caster recovers 24 HP each turn for each destroyed minion. All allies get plus 50% defense. Yeah, so he's like the 5-star version of Gobbler. So, yeah, that's cool. I don't know. I'm going to have to ask around and see if people who have leveled him like him. I'm not sure if this is enough to actually level him. I don't see enough minions on defenses. If you have him and you've leveled him and you've used him, leave a comment. Tell me how you like him. Is he worth the mats? Is he not worth the mats? I am hesitant to pull the trigger on this. I'm waiting for the masquerade of the gods or whatever that's called. So I'm just starting to level my, let me show you here. I'm basically just leveling my, I'm getting Nyx and Tinsel up to 370 because I don't have the mats for them. But when I do have the mats, these are the ones I'm going to be pulling the trigger on. And I'm finishing up some 4 stars and I'm finishing up some 3 stars in here. And then once I'm done with Tinsel and Nyx, I've got a bunch of dark 4-star heroes that I need to do. So I'll be working on them for a while here. Let's see, I've got my next priorities are going to be in blue is Captain of Diamonds for sure. He's one of the best anti-minion heroes, and now that I can double limit break him, he is going to do a lot of damage too. So I like him in 4-star. Yeah, what's his? See, it's 240 damage, so he's probably somewhere around 300% when he's leveled. He's only at level 1 on the special right now. So he's a good hitter. And yeah, I am going to do Ametrine. She prioritizes dispelling buffs from the target or from the target and nearby enemies at very fast and functionally fast speed. So she's going to be very useful. I have another Annabelle. I need Cupcake as a counter for Sorrow. I'm starting to see her more around now. And then Argus. He is like the 4-star version of Nyx. So I do want him. Man, I've just got a ton of Merlin hits 3 and does mindless attack. I've got another Cyprian to do here. So I've got a lot of 4-stars to get caught up on. So that's what I'm prioritizing for the next 2 weeks. But let's see here. Last thing I want to show you. Basically anything that I talk about, I'd like to show you. So Green Knight, I guess I stopped a little bit before 70, but he's at 46. And yeah, Hemos is at 260. You have Jade, and I'm just not ready to pull the trigger on any of these. Where did Matt go? There she is, right here. She's at 370, and I'm not sure. If you have Matt or Green Knight, let me know how you like them. The problem that I have pulling the trigger on them is they are defense down heroes, and I compare them with, I mean, I have a lot of heroes in the here. I have Hammer Tusk, which is attack up. Usually, you know, you're going to pair a defense down with a hitter. Or, you know, I have Guan Yu for the defense down. So I could pair someone up with Stain Tongue. But if I want to do a 3-stack, I'm going to do Guan Yu, Hammer Tusk, and Stain Tongue. I have Archie, but I haven't leveled him yet, so I could pair Matt with Archie, but that's 2 heroes I gotta level. And again, without a defensive specialist, I can't put together a team that I am used to using, and I've tried doing a 2-2-1 and it just doesn't work the same. It doesn't work as well without that defensive healer, putting a defensive specialist in another color. So, you know, put like Krampus with a blue specialist, you know, but then, I don't know, with a green defense down and then a green hitter is what I'm saying, but it doesn't seem to work as well. So, I don't know. Let me know your thoughts on this, and if you have any comments on any of those heroes I talked about, please leave those in there. I like hearing the comments from you guys about how you use heroes, and best of luck in the portal, and that's it. See you in the next video.